Welcome back to cost accounting class, and in this 35th session I'll be giving you the details regarding the implementation of activity based costing and also the list of cost drivers for various activities. Let us see what are the steps involved in implementing activity based costing. The very first step is to identify the activities and then classification of activities, determining the cost of activities, determining cost drivers for each activity, identify cost to products, and finally applying costs to products. Let us see identifying the activities. The first step in ABC is to identify those cost that is to be allocated. This is most critical step in the entire process. The organization needs to undertake an in-depth analysis of the operating processes of each responsibility center. After taking in-depth analysis, the different tasks in detail, the prime activity can be identified. For it, a cost-benefit analysis is required to be performed. So, in order to convert the raw material into finished goods and producing a goods or services, we have to identify number of activities to be allocated or number of activities to be performed. So this is very critical point, because we have to check on all the details of that process of the cost in order to convert it into final product. So what will be the activities, number of activities are to be identified, and also cost benefit analysis is required to be performed. Cost benefit means what will be the benefit or what will be the advantage, and to in order to acquire that benefit or advantage, what will be the cost. Always cost should be lower than the benefit. So this cost, after analyzing the cost benefit analysis, we have to check on what are the activities to be performed. And the next step is classification of activities. An aggregate of closely related tasks is called an activity. For example, issuing materials to production activity involves a series of acts like placing order, receiving order, storing, etc. So all these three fall under same group. That is, these are related pertaining to production activity, that is issuing materials to the production. So under issuing materials to the production activity, placing order, receiving orders, and storing are interrelated. Such kind of activities are classified and grouped under one section. Thus an activity can comprise of one or more of tasks which are associated with one another to accomplish a goal. The main activities are unit level activity, batch level activity, product level activity, and facility level activities. These activities are being discussed in my last session, and I have given you in detail what does they mean. So under the main activities, we have to group which are closely related. Such activities are identified and classified and grouped under one section. And next step is to identify what will be the cost of these activities. So see, it is a step by step. First, identify the activities, and then we have to group them or we have to classify them, which are closely related, which are very rarely done activities. Those are being classified. And then what will be the cost of these activities are to be identified in third step. After identifying various cost activities and cost drivers, the next step is to determine the resources and cost of each activity. So what will be the resources used in order to perform that activity, and what will be the cost of that activity? Cost for various activities must be traced to create cost pools. This will help for distribution of costs. For example, a cost pool may be procurement of goods, Here, all costs associated with ordering, inspection, and storing, etc., would be included in this cost pool. So, which fall under related tasks are being grouped and identified, and what will be the cost of such activities are being identified. And the next step is determining cost drivers for each activity. Cost driver is any factor which cause a change in the cost of an activity. In simple words, identifying the factors which determine the cost of an activity is called as cost drivers. Here, factors can be taken as resources. What are the resources that cause the cost, that drives the cost to an activity is being determined. So in order to identify the cost of activity, we have to look on what are the resources to be used or the what are the factors to be used in order to incur the cost to that particular activity is to be determined in fourth step. And the next one is identifying cost to product. A predetermined rate is estimated for each resource driver. Such predetermined rate is estimated by dividing the cost pool by estimated level of cost driver. And finally, applying cost to products. The cost driver rates are applied to products. The aggregate cost can be computed by multiplying the rate of consumption of resources, that is cost driver rate, with the number of activity. So these two steps will come to know when you go for solving some problems. When we attempt in solving some practical problems, then we can understand these points very easily. And these are the steps involved in implementing ABC. Now let's see the list of cost drivers for various activities. So these are very important things wherein which are useful while calculating the problems. So you have to identify the cost drivers for the activities and then apply some formula and come out with the costs. The main activities are first one, customer order processing. The cost drivers applied may be called order value, order sources, that is new or old customers, order source, customer location. So if these three items, one of these is given in the problem, this can be applied for customer order process as a cost driver. Material planning and acquisition, for this we have to take cost driver as number of material requisition, volume of material receipts, volume of material orders. So they'll be giving you one or two drivers. You have to identify which drivers can be applied to what activity. Next, inspection. Inspection plans, number of problem suppliers, gauge usage, lack of good quality. And next is production control, engineering changes, supplies performance, number of parts operational, make versus buy policy, number of machine changes, order brought changes. And for production activity, cost drivers are number to be supervised, shift patterns, industrial relation issues, flow of product from assembly, volume of service parts, kit package, etc. And next, for maintenance, number of machine breakdowns, machine schedule, maintenance schedule, capital expenditure, activity levels. And for systems activity, number of systems operational, number of systems devices, and adequacy of existing systems. Quality control, inspection plan will be the cost drivers. Financial accounting, number of accounting transaction, number of times accounts produced, volume of activity, coordinated shipping process, management accounting, accuracy of feeder systems, management requirement, corporate requirement, activity levels. And finally, for personal activity, recruitment activity, industrial relation climate, training, equipment. These are the activities and the cost drivers. And this was the things which I wanted to share in this session. I'll be back with the difference between the traditional and ABC methods of costing in my next session. Until then, have a nice time. Thank you very much.